हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ चौधरी प्रियंका नागेश, आई एम फ्रॉम रयत शिक्षण संस्था RBNB कॉलेज श्रीरामपुर. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द 12th साइंस फिजिक्स थर्ड चैप्टर काइनेटिक थ्योरी ऑफ गैसेस एंड रेडिएशन. सो द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इज रूट मीन स्क्वेयर स्पीड. रूट मीन स्क्वेयर इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड RMS स्पीड. द रिलेशन बिटवीन प्रेशर ऑफ ए गैस एंड मॉलिक्युलर स्पीड इज गिवन बाय P इज इक्वल टू 1/3 N/V mv²/bar. P is pressure of gas, N is number of molecules in a gas, V is volume of box, and v²/bar is the molecular speed of a gas, M is the mass of gas. So the rearranging this equation, so by rearranging the equation we can write this v²/bar is equal to three here, so 3PV/N×M. Now by using ideal gas equation, so the ideal gas equation is PV is equal to nRT. So we use this equation here. So the equation can be written as v²/bar is equal to 3 instead of PV nRT divided by N×M. Here small n is the number of moles in the gas, so the number of moles n is given by n is equal to number of molecules of gas divided by Na is Avogadro number. Now substituting this value of n in this equation, we can write here 3nRT divided by n×Na×M. So now by simplifying this equation, so this capital N on numerator and denominator gets cancelled, so we can write v²/bar is equal to 3RT/NA×M. But Avogadro's number Na into m is the molar mass. So molar mass is denoted by m0. So m0 is equal to Na into m. So now in this equation we can substitute this value m0. So we can write the same equation as V square bar is equal to 3RT upon m0. Now we have to find root mean square, that is RMS speed. So this root mean square speed can be given by under root or square root of V square bar. It is called root mean square speed. It is also written as V RMS, and which is equal to, from this equation, under root 3RT upon m0. So this equation gives us root mean square speed for the gas molecules. Then the next point that we are going to study is the next point. So we will study the next point, interpretation of temperature in kinetic theory. Interpretation of temperature in kinetic theory. So now we have to interpret the temperature in kinetic theory. So we will consider the expression for pressure in case of ideal gas molecules. So we have P is equal to 1 upon 3 N upon V, this V is volume, mv square bar. So now we can rearrange this equation. So rearranging the equation, we get PV is equal to 1 upon 3 N into mv square bar. So now in this equation we are multiplying and dividing by 2, we get PV is equal to 2 upon 3 into N into 1 by 2 mv square bar. So now this 1 by 2 mv square bar is the average kinetic energy. Then there are, in case of ideal gas, the gas molecules are non-interacting. So the potential energy term in total energy is zero. So the total energy of ideal gas molecules can be given by only kinetic energy. So the total energy E is equal to N into one upon two mv square bar. N is total number of molecules. Now substituting this value of E in this equation, we can write the equation as PV is equal to 2 upon 3 E. Means instead of this value, we have substituted total energy E. So now, by using ideal gas equation, so ideal gas equation is PV is equal to NKBT. So by comparing these two equations, we can write so this PV is equal to 2 upon 3 E is equal to NKBT. So now by equating these two equations, we can write E is equal to, by using these two equations, E is equal to 3 upon 2 N KB into T. So again, we can write this equation as E upon N is equal to 3 upon 2 KB into T. So now from this equation, the energy of gas molecules per unit number of molecules is directly proportional to the temperature T. This is a constant value. KB is Boltzmann constant. So now from this equation, we can interpret the temperature in kinetic theory. Then the next point that we are going to study is degrees of freedom. Next point is degrees of freedom. Suppose there is a gas molecule moving along a straight path. A gas molecule moving along straight path, then the position of that gas molecule is given by the coordinate x, and the velocity component for this gas molecule is Vx. Now, if a molecule is moving in two-dimensional plane surface, so the coordinates for this molecule is x, y. and the velocity component is given by Vx, Vy. Then a molecule is moving in three-dimensional space. Then this molecule has coordinates x, y, z, and velocity components are Vx, Vy, Vz. So now the degrees of freedom in these three cases are, in case first, the total number of degrees of freedom here, DOF, that is degrees of freedom, is 1. For this two-dimensional plane, a molecule has degrees of freedom 2. Then for three-dimensional space, a molecule has total number of degrees of freedom 3. So from this, we can define the degrees of freedom as, degrees of freedom is defined as the total number of coordinates or independent quantities required to describe a physical quantity completely. Then it is called the degrees of freedom. Then the next point that we are going to study is diatomic molecules. Next point is diatomic molecules. So to consider diatomic molecules, first we will consider the figure. So these are x, y, and z axis. So here, these are diatomic molecules. So diatomic molecules means having two atoms. So for example, O2, that is oxygen, then N2, that is nitrogen. These are the some examples of diatomic molecules. So these molecules having two atoms. So these diatomic molecules are moving along their center of mass in a direction perpendicular to its molecular axis. So consider these diatomic molecules. Suppose it is a O2, that is oxygen. So these diatomic molecules are rotating along the axis. So the total number of translational degrees of freedom for diatomic molecules is 3. So translational degrees of freedom for diatomic molecules is 3. So in addition to translational degrees of freedom, the diatomic molecules has rotational degrees of freedom. So the rotational rotational degrees of freedom is 2. So the total number of degrees of freedom for diatomic molecules are 5, 3 translational plus 2 rotational. So the total number of total number of degrees of freedom is 5. So now from this equation we can write if Iz and Iy are moment of inertia along z and y axis. Moment of inertia along z and y axis, and omega z and omega y are angular frequency respectively, then the energy can be written as, or the rotational kinetic energy can be written as one upon two Iz omega z square plus 1 upon 2 Iy omega y square. Also the translational plus rotational, so the total energy of a diatomic molecule can be given by addition of rotational kinetic energy and translational kinetic energy. So this energy is E is equal to 1 upon 2 mvx square plus 1 upon 2 mvy square plus 1 upon 2 mvz square. This is the translational kinetic energy plus rotational kinetic energy can be written as 1 by 2 Iz omega z square plus 1 upon 2 Iy omega y square. So when diatomic molecules are rotating, so in their total energy some vibrational energy also added. So the total energy of the diatomic molecule is E is equal to 1 translational plus E rotational plus E vibrational. So now this gives us the total kinetic energy of a diatomic molecules. So now from this we can write the total energy E is kinetic energy plus potential energy. So here E is equal to 1 upon 2 mu square plus 1 upon 2 k r square. So this gives the total energy of a diatomic molecules. So now if we see these equations, so in these equations the quadratic term is present. So in general the energy of diatomic molecules has one upon two kBT term. Means if there is a rotational kinetic energy, then the rotational kinetic energy is given by 2 into 1 upon 2 kBT. This 2 is total number of degrees of freedom. Then if we have to find the translational kinetic energy, then we can find it into 1 upon 2 kBT. So from this we can find the energy of diatomic molecules. Thank you.